In this session, we are going to start arithmetic progressions, a new chapter today. So, for that, I'll present the screen. A small presentation I have, I'll show you that. And during the presentation, we learn how to do the problems from the exercises given in the textbook. So, let us see the presentation. Here is the one. Right. So arithmetic progressions, what are these? What are these we learn? Here in I have a section with certain series of numbers. Okay? Some sets of numbers I am giving here. Think you guess what would be the next number. Try to guess what will be the next number in that series. 25, 40, 30, 18. Try guessing the next number. Can you guess it? You try. It is not easy. It is not looking easy. Is it not? 25. When 15 is added, 40 you are getting. Now 10 is reduced. Again, 12 is reduced. We don't know what will be happening to the next number. How much will be reduced, we don't know. Next, here, 20, a 0 has come, 10, 17. This is also looking quite odd. We don't know, we cannot guess the number easily, next number easily. See, the third one, even this is not easy. So, here, of course, a little bit of guesswork can be done like this. 32, and the third term or third number in the series is 16, half of it. So, fifth number would be half of it. We don't know exactly, but we can guess like that. Even the same may be there because 40 here and 20 here, it is reduced to half. So, sixth number would be half of this one. So, 32, 40, 16, 20. Next would be 8 and 10, maybe. So, some work can, guesswork can be done. Okay, in section B, I have some more numbers. Let us see whether you will be able to guess those next numbers. See here. 10, 20, 30, 40. Can you guess the next one?
50, 50, 50, 50, 50.
It is very easily coming to our mind. It is very easily coming to our mind. Next number here.
2, 4, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10,
But in this slide, we could easily guess what is the next one. That means why we are able to do so? Because the given set of numbers, the series of numbers here, they are following a rule. They are following a rule. So such series of numbers, such list of numbers is called arithmetic progressions. Arithmetic progression. Such list of numbers is said to form an arithmetic progression. So in this, an arithmetic, what is an arithmetic progression we will be able to define now. Given a particular number, starting with a particular number, if the next number is coming by adding a fixed number to that, and every number is coming like that, every next number is coming in the list by adding a fixed number to the previous one, then such a list of numbers, such a series of numbers is called arithmetic progression. Okay, in this, the fixed number being added can be positive or zero or can be negative also. So this is the definition, children. An arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. The first term is denoted with letter A or A1. Okay, A1. A1 should be a subscript, of course, little down the right from the normal line. Okay, next. the fixed number is called the common difference of the particular arithmetic progression. It can be positive, negative or zero, denoted with letter D. Okay, this is what an arithmetic progression is. Right. Next, we have how to know whether given list of numbers is an arithmetic progression or not. Let us understand this. How do we know? Suppose this is the numbers, let us consider the list first here. 4, 10, 16, 22. You can guess the next number because it is following a rule. But how to prove that it is an arithmetic progression very logically? Let us see that. Here the first term or A is equal to 4. Next, second term is denoted with the letter A2, with symbol A2, that is 10. And third term, symbol A3, it is 16. Fourth term is 22, and so on. Those three dots at the end denote that the progression is continuing. It continues. So many numbers are there. We don't know what is the last term, last number in the series, in the list. If the three dots are not given, then only some numbers are given. That is called a finite set or finite list of numbers or finite arithmetic progression. If the number of terms in a progression is finite, then it is called a finite arithmetic progression. If the progression is continuing and we don't know the last number in the series, such a progression is called infinite arithmetic progression. Okay, now let us come back to the lesson. Here 4 is the first term, 10 is the second one, 16 is the third one, and 22 is the fourth one. Now let us take the difference between the second term and the first term. A2 minus A1 is 6. That is the difference, first difference. Second difference, let us see, that is third term minus second term, that is also 6. And now you check fourth term minus third term, that is also 6. All the differences are equal here, therefore it is an arithmetic progression. It is an arithmetic progression. This is how you can decide whether given set of numbers, given list of numbers is form an arithmetic progression or not. It forms here, the list forms an arithmetic progression because the differences are equal. We can also, so since the differences are equal, the given list of numbers, actually numbers should be there here. Okay, numbers form an AP. This, can you recognize what is given here? 11, 17, 23, 29, 35, 41, 47, 53. This is a list of numbers. Did you get anything? Did you recollect anything by seeing this? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is that?
Sir, adding 6, sir.
Pooja, you are recollecting that. Of course, that is given down below. This picture I gave you in the poster yesterday, did you remember that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's like that.
That means you are not observing carefully. Observe carefully. Remember, certain things can be recollected easily. Okay. Now, every second number is obtained by adding 6 to the previous one. Of course, leaving 7, 11 here. So, 11 is the first member or the first number in this series, in this progression. 11 is called the first term, and all other terms are obtained by simply adding 6 to the previous one. Okay, so this is also an arithmetic progression. This is also an arithmetic progression. Now let us move on to the next one. Here we have 2, 4, 8, 16, a series of numbers. Of course, this is an exercise textbook question from exercise 5.1, 4, 1. Okay, whether these four numbers are these of course infinite set of numbers, will this form an arithmetic progression or not? Let us check. Once again, the series is this. Again, a1 is 2, a2 is 4, a3 is 8, a4 is, again now we will not go further, a2 minus a1 we will check, that is 4 minus 2, that is 2, a3 minus a2 also we check, that is 4. Are they equal now, a2 minus a1 and a3 minus a2? They are not equal. As a2 minus a1 is not equal to a3 minus a2, we say these numbers will not form an arithmetic progression. So this series is not an AP. The given series does not form an arithmetic progression. Did you understand how to? Now the previous slide, in the fifth slide, what I gave here, in the fifth slide, oh my god, this one, you can see 4, 10, 6, 22, all the differences are equal, therefore they are forming an arithmetic progression. Though here the d value is same, it is a different arithmetic progression from this one. It is starting with number 11, a is different, here a is different, but the differences are equal, okay, let it be. But in the next one, here we are having 2, 8, 2, 4, 8, 16. In this, the differences are not equal. 4 minus 2 is not equal to 8 minus 4 or not equal to 16 minus 8 also. Therefore, the differences between the consecutive numbers, consecutive terms of this series are not equal. Therefore, we say it does not form an AP. I think you are understanding a bit, but still a confusion is there in the mind. Therefore, to remove that confusion, let us check two more examples. Vaikundapati, are you following? Vaikundapati, are you there? Are you following? Jyotirmayi? Yes, yes. Vaikundapati is not replying. Bhavya? Are you following, Bhavya?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, let us move on to the next one. Here is a series of numbers again. Of course, these are decimals. Right? Minus 1.2, minus 3.2, minus 5.2, minus 7.2. Okay. And here the first term, A1, is minus 1.2. And the second term is minus 3.2. Third term is A3, that is minus 5.2, and the fourth term is minus 7.2. Again, we take the differences, A2 minus A1, that is minus 3.2 minus 1.2. Here, minus of minus will become plus. So, minus 3.2 plus 1.2, negative decimal has more value, more numerical value. So, from this, negative number, we subtract the positive one, 3.2 minus 1.2, that is 2, but negative symbol will keep minus 2. Did you understand this subtraction, Tanush? Tanush? Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Sir, please, please repeat again, sir.
Okay, here, minus 3.2 is the second term, and minus 1.2 is the first term. I am subtracting minus 1.2, that is the first term, from the second term, minus 3.2. So, when the subtraction is taking place, minus of minus is plus here. So, this will become plus 1.2. And this is minus 3.2. The sum of plus 1.2 and minus 3.2 is negative, because one is a positive integer, another is a negative integer. Negative integer or the negative decimal has more value, so the symbol comes as negative. The difference is the result. 3.2 minus 1.2 is 2, but negative here. Did you understand? Whoever asked, see the next one.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
Minus 5.2, minus of minus 3.2. Same is the case here. This will become positive. So, minus 5.2 plus 3.2, again minus 2. Again, A4 minus A3 also is minus 2. All differences are equal. Therefore, A2 minus A1 equal to A3 minus A2 equal to A4 minus A3. So, all differences are equal. Therefore, these numbers, that they form an arithmetic progression, AP. Now, let us take one more example here, children. Minus 10, minus 6, minus 2, and 2. Some negative integers, some one positive integer also is there. Let us see what is the first term, that is minus 10. Second term a2 is minus 6. Third term is minus 2. Fourth term a4 is minus, a4 is 2 actually here. One second. Let me go back and check this. Yeah, this one, na? Right. This is 2. Okay, from the current slide. Right, common difference, let it be D. What is that difference? Let us find out. A2 minus A1, that is minus 6 minus of minus 10. This will become plus 10. Minus 6 plus 10. So, positive number has more value. So, 10 minus 6, we take it as 10 minus 6, 4, but positive symbol. Similarly, minus 2 minus of minus 6 or minus 2 plus 6, again 4. Now, 2 minus of minus 2, that is 2 plus 2, 4. So, all the differences are equal. A2 minus A1 equal to A3 minus A2 equal to A4 minus A3. So, all the three differences are equal or whatever it is, you take the other number also. So, therefore, these numbers form an AP. Now, is it clear to you all children how to find out whether given a set of numbers form an AP or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please, understand.
Yes, sir.
Every small question is important from this chapter because these will give you a basis for doing problems on series in the competitive exams. If you are thorough with this chapter, you will get the ideas quickly to solve questions based on series problems in competitive exams. So it is good for you, for your future also. So therefore, you learn this one thoroughly with all interest. Okay, shall we move on to the next question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Here is the one. Here we have certain rational numbers, irrational numbers together. 3, 3 plus root 2, 3 plus 2 root 2, 3 plus 3 root 2. These are the four numbers. 3 is the first term in the series. 3 plus root 2 is the second term. 3 plus 2 root 2, 3 plus 3 root 2. This is the third term. You can very well understand that and say that it is a series, it is an AP because see, for the first term root 2 is added. Second term, one more root 2 is added. Third term, one more root 2 is added. So, here 2 root 2s, here 3 root 2s. And fourth term will be 4 root 2s will be there. Is it not? So, the next term will be. So, like this it is coming. Therefore, it is AP, definite. But we will prove it logically. So, here the first term A1 is 3. Second term is 3 plus root 2, third term is 3 plus 2 root 2, fourth term is 3 plus 3 root 2. Now, once again, we'll subtractions we take D, let the common difference be D, whether it is same or not, we'll check. A2 minus A1 equal to 3 plus root 2 minus 3, it is simply root 2. This 3 and this 3 are getting cancelled and we are left with root 2 here. Now, here, 3 plus 2 root 2 minus 3 plus root 2. 3 minus 3 cancel. 2 root 2 minus root 2. From 2 rotis, 1 roti is eaten, so 1 roti is left out. So it is root 2. Next, A4 minus A3 equal to 3 plus 3 root 2. Sorry, 3 plus 3 root 2 minus 3 plus 2 root 2 here. 2 root 2, right? So, therefore, here what is happening? 3 minus 3 cancels. 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2. That means 3 apples minus 2 apples. It is 2 apples, again 1 apple here. 3 apples minus 2 apples is 1 apple. So, here you can see the differences are equal. Root 2, root 2 and root 2. Therefore, the set of numbers given here form an AP. Is that clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. We move on to the next one. Now, suppose you are given first term, first four terms of an AP. The first term is A, and the common difference of D, common difference D are given. How to write the first four terms of an AP? How to find those terms? We'll understand now. So here, given A equal to 10, that is the first term, and the difference is 10. That means, what is the actual definition of the arithmetic progression? In an arithmetic progression, leaving the first number, every other term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the previous one. Here the first one is 10, we add this difference to this one now. Then you get the second term. Here A is 10, D is 10. Therefore, let the series be A1, A2, A3, A4. So A2 is obtained by adding D to A. D to A. A1 equal to A equal to 10. A2 equal to A1 plus D, that is 10 plus 10, 20. Next, A3 equal to A2 plus 1 more D, that is 20 plus 10, 30. A4 equal to A3 minus D, A3 plus D, that is 30 plus 10, 40. A5 equal to A4 plus D, 40 plus 10, 50. Like this, you can have a number of, a series you can have 10, 20, 30, 40. All these are the first terms in this AP. Therefore, first four terms will be 10, 20, 30, 40. Did you understand this question? Simply add 10 to the first one, D to the first one. Simple addition. You get 20. To this 20, again you add 10, you get 30. To this 30, again 10 you add, you get 40. 10 plus 10, plus 10 again, plus 10, plus 10. This forms an AP. So if you know the first term and the common difference, you can very well write the AP very easily. Now, see this question. Write first four terms of the AP when the first term A and the common difference D are given as follows. A equal to minus 2, D equal to 0. D equal to 0. So I have to add again A1, A2, A3, A4. I will say these are the terms in the series. A1 is minus 2. A2 will be minus 2 plus 0, minus 2 again. A3 will be A2, that is the third term, a second term, plus common difference D is again 0, minus 2, minus 2. So all the terms in this series will be minus 2, minus 2, minus 2. Still, it is an AP, and the first four terms are minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, and minus 2. The specialty of this particular series, or this particular arithmetic progression, is that the common difference is 0. We already learned in the previous slides that the definition of AP says that common difference can be positive, negative, or 0. So here, common difference is 0. Okay, so these are the textbook questions, children. I am now solving. I am going to send this the portable document file also. I will send. Copy all these questions in your classwork so that you will have a notes for this particular chapter. Okay, now let us see one more question on this checking or finding the first four terms of the AP when the first term and the common difference are given. First term is 4 and the common difference is minus 3 this time, negative. So let the number series be A1, A2, A3, A4. A1 equal to A equal to 4. A2 equal to A1 plus D, that is 4 plus minus 3 or 4 minus 3, it is 1. Then the second term is A2 plus D. A2 is 1 plus D is minus 3. 1 minus 3, it is minus 2. Because negative number has more value. From that we subtract the positive and put the symbol of negative. That is what is called addition of integers. Next, A4 is A3 plus D, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5. And then the series will be like this. 4 1, minus 2, minus 5. So what are the first four terms of the AP? 4, 1, minus 2, minus 5. And next number, if you want, it will be minus 8, because minus 5 plus minus 3 will be minus 8, minus 11, minus 14, it goes on and on. So could you get this answer now, all of you?
Shall yes, sir.
Now we will move on to another important small simple concept here. Suppose this series of numbers is given, and we know that it is an AP. If we know that it is an AP, then what is the first term and what is the common difference? We will be able to find like this. First term, locating the first term is simple. The whatever number that appears in the beginning of the series is the first term. That's all. So here, given series is this. So first term A is 3. Common difference is equal to second term minus first term. 1 minus 3. That is nothing but minus 2. This is how you can get the first term and the common difference. Very simple, no? Shall we see another example of this kind? Very good.
Yes, sir.
Now, let us see this series. Minus 5, minus 1, 3, 7. It is given that it is an AP. We need to find the first term and the common difference. So, the first term is the number given in the beginning of the series, that is minus 5. A is minus 5. Common difference D equal to second term minus first term minus 1 minus of minus 5, that is plus 5 minus 1 plus 5 or minus 1 plus 5 is okay. I think I did not give you the answer there. I will give you equal to 4. Equal to 4. 4 is added there. Okay. Now we'll move on to the next one. So this is the question, children. Minus 1 minus of minus 5, it is plus 5. Minus 1 plus 5 is 4. Now one more example we check quickly. First term and common difference we require. That is 0.6, 1.7, 2.8, 3.9. Now first term is very well known. That is the first number in the series, that is 0.6. And the common difference is second term minus first term. What is the second term? 1.7. What is the first term? 0.6. 1.7 minus 0.6 is 1.1. This is the common difference. Got it? Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir. No, sir.
Now, we will learn from here tomorrow. Nth term of an AP, we will learn this concept tomorrow. Now, so far what we have seen? We have seen that what is an AP we have seen? Some series of numbers when they are given, we understood that these series of numbers are not APs, or we cannot guess the next number. Here, we are able to guess the next number because that they are following a particular rule. And then the definition of AP we learned. After finding the definition, how to find whether given series of numbers is an AP or not, which we understood, and then we considered some examples here. Okay, then we also learned how to find the first four numbers of an AP when the common difference and the first term are given. When the common difference and the first term are given, very simple, go on adding the common difference to the number, first number and the previous number, and go on A1, A2, A3, etc. A1 is the first number given already. Okay. Next, A2 is given. A2 is taken as A1 plus D, that is 10 plus 10. Then A3 is A2 plus D. Again, A4 is A3 plus D, and so on. And we can follow, we can easily understand what are the first few members or first few terms of the AP. Suppose an AP is given directly, we will be able to find its first term and the common difference like this. So these are the three concepts we learned today, and with this we conclude the class for today.